Hello, welcome back to my channel Tutor Things. Today in this video we are going to see all about the component in Angular. So what are meant by components in Angular, how we use those components, so all these things I am going to discuss in this video. So before getting started into this video, I want to mention one thing, that is if you haven't subscribed to my channel till yet, please subscribe and click the bell icon so that you will never miss any update from us. You will get notified each time when we upload a new video. So you all know about the thing which we have started, the Angular tutorials, right? So we have developed, we have covered so many concepts and created videos on that. So if you haven't watched those previously, go to my channel and check out the playlist called as Angular. And not only Angular, we have done so many playlists related to web development concepts such as HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery concepts, and also the other concepts. Please check out all the playlists so that definitely will help you, and I'm sure about it. So let's see what is meant by components. So in the previous videos we have seen like directives, what are the directives we have in Angular. So knowing about the components we have in Angular is also pretty much important. So why we use this component? As we have created the first application, like first project in Angular, we have an inbuilt component called as an app component. You all know about that. So that is component. So component, the main use of component is where we have the binding code. For binding purpose we use these components. So what is binding? What we are binding? We are binding the JSON response which you are getting from API or any other back end, so that to be binded with the front end view, that is Angular like component, like views. So binding the data to the view is nothing but binding what we are doing in the component level. So okay, so binding will take place by this component. The use of component is to make the binding process. Okay, so for that the component, I will give a practical example by using this Stackbliss website. So we know about Stackbliss, like from starting Angular tutorials I'm using this Stackbliss to show you the instant examples through the online platform, that is this Stackbliss. So whenever you click on Angular, your project will be created within minutes, milliseconds. So no need to do anything from the start and creating applications, so that will download all the packages, that will take so much of time. So by using this online platform, you can do everything within minutes. So here we don't have any terminal to generate any kind of component or any other services. What you have to do is, here you have to right click by giving the source, and Angular generator is one there where you want to generate any component or service or directive or module or anything. You can just click on that, so that will be created and you can see that in the folder form. So this is the thing which we have here. So 1 minute, I will charge. So in Angular, what we have, let's see. So this is the one of the component, right? App component, which we have like default component. When we create an application, you will have this app component. So we have seen what is meant by a component. So let's see what are the things present in a component. So a component will have these kind of things. One is template. So template is nothing but view or HTML, we call this. That is a front end thing. So template is nothing but, here you can see component is a collection of template styles and those things. So template, you can mention the template either in the template URL form or in the direct template form only. Template URL, where we have to give the path of that HTML file which we use for that component. So this is the .html file for the app component. So that we have to mention the template URL. So component, when we say component, the particular related HTML file is also the part in the component. Okay, that is the one part which we have to remember while in the case of component. And next one is class. So for coding purpose, we are saying that component is used for binding, right? So for binding purpose, we should have a class for any component. So collection of these things will form a component. So class should be mandatory. So the class name will be there. And in the class, what we have, basically in the class, we have like a code, we have like any logic we will develop in the class, and our TypeScripts, like TypeScripting will be there, like on this action, what should be done likewise. And data and methods will be there. You can mention any method like a hide method, a show method, submit method, like by giving it methods we can give and properties we can give, TypeScripts, data types. So like this, all these things we can do it in the class level. Okay, now what we have is metadata. So any extra information, or we can call it as metadata, or so decorator. So here @ is nothing but decorator, component decorator we have used. So like that we can use any other decorators also. Here selector is there, so styles are there, and next this extra information like selector my app is there, so that we can use that in the other place. So all these are called as a collection of all these things can call it as a component. So okay, so we have seen why we use component, that is for binding purpose, and what are the things present in a component we have seen. And let's see the files related to components. For one component you will have 4 files related to that. So for example, if it's an app component, you have component app.component.ts file, that's a TypeScript file will be there, and .html app.component.html file, where we have .html file and app.component.css file. So CSS stylings will be included in this file. So apart from this, one more file is there, that is spc.ts. So for testing purpose of particular app component, we'll have one file. So that is not missing in this online platform, because testing will not happen in this online stack blade. So that will not present. If you are running, creating application in the local machine, you can see that file also. So 4 files will be created when we are creating a new component. So unlike this, you will have another type of component also, where you don't need to have the file for HTML and CSS. You can include those stylings and template kind of things in the TS file only. Let's see how we can do. Here you can have a hello component with an example. So here you can see the decorator is there, that's extra information. Where is the selector is there, hello. So whatever the string we can give, so that we can use that in the other cases. So next we have template. Here you can see a template is mentioned here. Unlike template URL, we haven't giving any file name or file path. Here we are giving that template whatever mentioning in the TS file itself. Stylings also we can mention that here itself by following the syntaxes. Here square brackets will be there, and next quotations we have to specify. So like this, we can create only one TS file for a particular component, so that we'll have HTML and CSS things also included in that. So I think you got clarity, right? So by using this selector name or thing, we can include that in any other component, so that those changes will reflect in that component. Here where I'm using hello a tag here, like what is, we can call it as component directives, or custom directives we can call it as. So we have made a video on that. So what is this hello we are using, like input, how we are passing name. So you can check out that custom directive kind of video, so that you'll understand. Let's see how to create an other component. So instead, when you are at local machine, you can go to terminal, you can give ng generate component and component name, so that you will get 4 files, or otherwise you can create one folder and you can create each individual file like that. Because this is a stack based online platform, you will not have a terminal. So like this, you can use Angular generator kind of thing. When you give right click to the source, you will get this option. So here click on component and just give the name of the component, like my component you can give, like home component you can give. So likewise, I am giving home, I'm clicking enter. So just when clicking on enter, you got a home folder, and where we have all these CSS and HTML and TS files for the home.component.html file, home.component.cs file, and home.component.ts file. So one thing you have to remember is, whenever you have created a component, you have to check one thing, that is in which module you are including this component. Okay, so module is nothing but the thing which have exports, declarations, and bootstrap kind of things. Like, so all these things we have to first declare it in the components. Here check, we have app component and the hello component which have seen previously. So now I have created one more component, that is a home component. So that thing also should be present in this declarations, then only we can completely created a component and declared that thing. So after mentioning that there, so what we can do is, we can make use of the component, home component, where we have HTML we called as a homeworks, right? So to use this component in other place, what you have to do is, this selector is there, right? So we have to use that selector, and we can place it in any component, so that you will have that you have to mention so whatever the HTML we have in that will be present here. So here you can see homeworks comes after this hello thing. So like this, we can use the components in other components or these kind of things by creating other components. So this will simplify the task and breaks the divisions likewise. So all the included information, related information, you can place in one component, like for login one component, for home one component, for register one component, or likewise. So based upon the application, you can create different kind of components to make your work simpler and look and easy, so that you can code better if these particular divisions will be there. So in the upcoming video, we are going to tell you about modules. So how modules will work. Modules are nothing but a collection of components, so that I will explain you in that video. So in this video, I think everyone is clear about components, what are the files we have in components, and how we can use component, like for binding purpose. Like see here, name is there. So your property is binding with the HTML. The name, same name comes here, like Angular and version. So these things, binding purpose, we use these things. Actually, component is a collection of like template, class, and metadata. So components are very useful in Angular. So default component we have is app component. So whatever the components we have to first declare those things in the module.ts file. So which module this component belongs to, we have to mention, right? So next, this is all about component. I think you are clear about it. If you have any doubts, extra doubts regarding to this component, you can feel free to comment in the comment section. We'll definitely reply to your comments. And like this video, if you generally don't know about component kind of things, feel free to share to your friends also who don't know about component kind of things. If you are watching my Angular videos all the so long, so check out all the other playlists also. That will definitely help you to know the things better. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.